is your moment. Take over.
Thank you, Jesus.
Take over. On my own, I can do nothing. Let your word come forth today with power. Let it be a definite word for someone here today, Lord. We come against every force that has been assigned to distract them today from receiving from you. We arrest them, we bind them, we cage them. In Jesus' name, amen. Sit down, please. Sit down and never go down. I think I like the joy in this place. I like the joy in this place. I was in a church where there were about 10,000 people, but they were begging them to shout hallelujah.
Mercy.
So like I was too noisy.
Amen.
They thought I was too noisy.
Wow.
And God told me that you see why I tell you to allow them to celebrate.
Amen.
Say what you see here is not, it's not normal. He said, this is the Holy Ghost.
My God.
Releasing joy unspeakable upon his people.
Yes.
Shout hallelujah.
Yes.
Celebrate him.
Yes.
Celebrate him.
You are
celebrate him. Celebrate him.
To you.
Celebrate him.
King.
In Jesus.
Him
we are giving thanks.
Amen. Amen.
Sit down. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
I also like that thing you beat there. It's very nice. That one. Yes, it's nice. I like it. Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, sometimes you don't know till you grab a revelation.
That's right.
Sometimes I'll just come here and say, no, I don't want anybody. I said, I just want to teach. And he began to tell me, that is not normal. Say, son, that's joy unspeakable. I'm releasing upon them.
That's right.
They'll beg them. Say hallelujah. So many things. You know, you can only see things like that when you go to somewhere else.
Yes, sir.
The testimonies we take here for granted. Someone, by the power of the Holy Ghost, that blood, it comes back. Suddenly, someone testified that as Papa spoke, the blood that she has not seen for 3 months.
Amen.
And yeah, we just take it like that. There it happened, the pastor rolled on the floor. It's too common here. Jesus.
I come to know Jesus.
Sit down. We learn. Hallelujah. We learn every day. I'm also learning like yourself. Shout hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know anything. I'm still learning.
Thank you, Jesus.
I just wanted to rest today because my bones, I need rest.
Amen.
I need what?
Rest.
My bones. All my bones are saying rest, 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 rest. Rest. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I already told Mama, I say, today, you and Pastor David will preach. I'll just sit down and watch. And the Holy Ghost began to cock my head. Say, bless them.
Amen.
Prepare hallelujah. Them for the next 6 months.
Amen.
Prepare them for the next 6 months.
Amen.
It does not matter what happened from January to now. When you are winning any team, whether it's 3-0 or in the first half, that is irrelevant, sir. There is always a comeback.
Amen.
There is always a bounce back.
Amen.
I prophesy by the power of the Holy Ghost. Someone hearing the sound of my voice, yes. This remainder of the year, yes. You shall bounce back.
Amen.
If that is you, let your amen sound like thunder.
Amen.
I say you shall bounce back.
Bounce back.
Sit down, please.
Thank you, Jesus.
A fresh anointing is not falling down. It's already here now.
Amen.
Sir, it's not that I pray for you, sit down, sir, and that you sit down. It's not that I pray for you and you fall down. It's not, now, we have it. So, you are privileged, oh. You
don't thank have you, Jesus. Yet.
You are so privileged.
Thank you. Holy
some of you will not understand that till when Jesus comes.
Amen.
You are privileged to have the one holding this microphone. So privileged.
Hallelujah.
So privileged. A fresh anointing is not even prophecy. It's not deliverance.
Amen.
The word of God when it's preached, it releases all that. The word of God is a sure word of prophecy.
That's right. Amen.
You guys don't understand. You are privileged, yo. In Africa, when they hear this prophecy, all of them will run there. When they feel like the prophecy will, this prophecy does not die. If I want to prophesy now, I'll prophesy. It does not
die.
It's a gift. It is free.
That's right.
But maturity is when you get to a point where you stop pleasing people, you start pleasing God. It's called maturity. How many times did Jesus prophesy? How many times? How many times did he call people and say, come, your name is, do you not know your name? It's not wrong to prophesy. Does that make sense? But we love the drama such that prophets have taken that now against people sitting down to bring about a drama instead of doing what God has assigned them to do. God only shows up on the scene when you are doing what he wants you to do.
Amen.
When you are out of his will for that service, he's not there. People might still be manifesting because those are gifts in the name of Jesus and the person falls. That may still happen. The choir may be singing and people are healed. But that's why many miracles don't last. That's why many don't last.
Mercy, Lord.
Because God is merciful. I might even say cancer be healed now. And it is healed.
Amen.
And he will allow that to happen, but the mercies of God are not the approval of God.
Of God. Amen.
That God allowed it to happen does not mean that he approves that you went against his will for the service.
That's right.
Every service before it happens, it had happened in heaven.
Happened already.
This service has happened in heaven already.
Amen.
That is why he told me clearly, go and bless them, because that is what has happened in heaven.
That's right.
So I must now replicate it on earth.
Amen.
I was meant to be here on Tuesday, sir. And I missed my flight for some reason. Anybody that says a plane is not good, if you are in this ministry, just pack your load and go.
Mercy, Lord. Mercy, mercy, mercy.
I miss it. And I said to Mama, I say, you should teach a thing on Thursday. Pastor David will teach on Friday. That was me talking. And the Holy Ghost said, no, so. Mama should preach Thursday and Friday. And Mama began to beg me, please, let Pastor David teach one day. Now her emotions, poking. But when I hear God, I just said to her, I have spoken. God has spoken, and that's what I'm telling you. She was begging, and I just said, bye-bye. That was it.
Hallelujah.
I don't know how she did, but she preached, right?
Hallelujah. We were blessed.
No, I don't go emotion. I'll not say Pastor David is very loyal. Let Pastor David teach on Friday. It's not a teaching competition. It's that the will of God, as it is in heaven, must be manifested on earth. Guess what? It could only be one person that may have been blessed by that service. That's the will of God.
Amen.
Be thou exalted. Be thou exalted. I feel the power of God here.
Omnipotent God, be thou exalted. Be thou exalted. Be thou exalted. Omnipotent God,
be thou exalted.
Be thou exalted.
Be thou exalted.
Be thou exalted.
First Kings 18, 43 to 45. The shouting prophet is back. First Kings 18, 43 to 45.
My God.
Let's read together. And said to his servant, go up now, look towards the sea. And he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. January, there is nothing. February, there is nothing. March, there is nothing. And he said, go again seven times. April, there was nothing. May, there was nothing. June, there was nothing. July.
The seventh time.
Verse 14. Quickly. Verse 14. And it came to pass at the seventh time. Not the fifth time. Not the fourth time. Not the third time. Not the first. And the seventh time. This month is the seventh month. And the seventh time. That is it. Behold, there arisen a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare the chariot and get it down, that the rain stop thee not. I don't know who I'm talking to. Starting from this 7 month, it is about to rain in your finances. It is about to run in your family.
Amen.
It is about to run in your business.
Amen.
It is about to run in your marriage.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for someone.
Thank you, Jesus.
In this 7 month of the year. I don't know where you have been delayed from January to now, but your situation is turning around. Your situation is turning around.
Amen.
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 If that is you, let your amen be the loudest.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
Sit down.
Thank you, Jesus.
notice that the servant was not tired of going again. Say, Nene, do you want to do it again? The servant did not say, prophet, it not go rain. Make I kill myself. Say, rain not go fall, leave I'm so. No. The servant did not say that. The prophet was to pray, the servant was to look. Watch and pray equation was balanced. This 7 months by the power of the Holy Ghost, I only speak to 10 persons hearing the sound of my voice. As you open your heart and obey prophetic instruction, I declare that nothing will stop your shining for in the name of Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, I prophesy to anyone who cares to believe. I don't know what has not worked from January till now. Starting in this mode of perfection, it shall work for you in the name of Jesus. Amen. It shall work for your marriage in the name of Jesus. Amen. It shall work for your family in the name of Jesus. Amen. I say what has not worked from January till now,
God,
there shall be abundance of it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say delays are broken in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That sickness must leave you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I prophesy.
I receive it.
Anyone,
yes, Lord,
whosoever,
thank you, Jesus,
whatsoever,
thank you, Jesus,
that may have blocked your promotion, that may have delayed your blessing,
yes, Lord,
from January to now,
my God,
right now by the power of the Holy Ghost,
yes,
we are risen by fire.
Amen.
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 In the name of
Amen.
Jesus. Anyone that refused to let you go, anyone that refused to let your healing, anyone that refused to let your blessings go,
mercy, Lord,
just like the Red Sea was opened,
yes, Lord,
and the Egyptians were swallowed,
that's right,
that one will be swallowed in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
That one will be swallowed in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
If that is you I spoke about, let your amen sound like thunder.
Amen.
Sit down.
Thank you, Jesus.
If that's all I did today, then I've done my... He said, bless them. Shout hallelujah.
My hallelujah.
Child of God, however,
Jesus,
all what we just did are prophecies.
My God.
But any prophecy without a condition,
mercy, Lord,
is only a mere incantation. Prophecies are prayer point.
Amen.
Any prophecy without a condition is a mere incantation. So therefore, to put heaven under pressure to bring about all what we may have said for the next 6 months in this second part of the year, we must first of all prepare ourselves to stand firm, like I said last time, in the midst of the storms. There will be storms. Word and fire ministry were meant to expand by now.
Yes.
Will it happen?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. No shaking.
Yes.
No doubt.
It's not maybe. It's not.
No,
it's,
no.
It's a must.
Hallelujah.
It's what? A must.
A must.
The devil can only delay your blessings. Does that make any sense?
Yes.
But he cannot stop them.
Amen.
He cannot
stop it.
I come here and I say, oh, this guy have not still expand. I begin to preach like I'm a baby preacher. No, no, no. That's not faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for.
And the evidence
of things not yet seen. You are waiting to see them before you believe them. Then it's an error.
Wrong place.
For you, I'm preaching to less than 100 people or more than 100 people. To me, I'm preaching to 1 million people.
A crowd.
Sir, more now, even as it were, before when I just got the mandate.
Amen.
It cannot change.
Amen.
Situations of life cannot change that,
that's
sir.
Right. That's right. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Because we are not moved by what we see. We are only moved by what the Spirit of the Lord says. Anytime you are giving a prophecy, there will be storms. Anytime you are giving a prophecy, there will be
storms.
Storms of life. They are inevitable. As long as you are a Christian, they are inevitable. Some of us don't like that, right? Luke 8, 22, 25. Quickly, because of time. Emmanuel. Let's read together. Let your voices sound like thunder. Now it came to pass, on a certain day,
that
he went into the ship with his disciples. And he said unto them, let us go over unto where? The other side of the lake. And they launched forth. I like the other verses, verse 3. Every day of my life, I'm waiting for storms. How do I know that something's about to happen? Storms of life. Storms of life.
That's right.
Storms of life.
That's
I'm telling you, sir, every day of my life, where is the next storm? When is the next storm?
Hallelujah.
When you are prepared for it, when it comes, you are unmovable.
Amen.
You are unshakable.
Thank you.
You are unmolestable.
Amen.
Because you are prepared for it.
That's right.
In your marriage, you think there will not be storm? There will be storms. There will be what? Some days you'll be looking at the person next to you, you're like, did I really marry? Storms of life. Change her, please. Storms of life. She's about to scream. Storms of life. They'll come. It's inevitable, sir. It's inevitable.
Hallelujah.
She's been holding it. She's holding it. It's inevitable. Storms of life. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How did Jesus calm the storm? Was it by mere confession? No, sir. But by speaking out loudly to the storm and commanding that storm to go. Whether you know it or not, child of God, storms of life are inevitable. But it is how you handle them that will determine what comes to you and when. Nahum 1:7. It says what? The Lord is good. A stronghold what? In the day of trouble. You see that? So there is a day of trouble. Sir, it doesn't matter whether you're a billionaire. There will be a day of financial
trouble.
There will be. In the day of trouble. And he knoweth them that trust in him. When? In that day of trouble. So God is watching your trust for him in the day of trouble. So if you are not spiritually and physically prepared for the day of trouble, you will disappoint heaven. No one here will be a reproach to heaven in the name of Jesus. I say you will not be a reproach to heaven in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And these storms assigned to contend against us, what we are seeing here, sir, is a storm.
Thank you, Jesus.
It has been fired to stop enlargement. Sir, many people are not coming to church because someone had fired an arrow in someone else to go and tell them that that pastor is not really sick.
That's right.
Hallelujah. And you'll be surprised that even you looking at me now, you know that I'm not fake, but it comes with, it's an arrow. When he enters you, you are surprised that the same you who came here and testified, that pastor, follow him. You'll be turning around and say, that man is so fake. The same person. Don't blame them. God said, don't blame them. Pray for them.
Amen.
Pray for them. Chinere, don't mind me using you, right? You know I love you so much. I remember her telling her her passport number.
Amen.
Did you give your passport number to anyone? Did you show me your passport number? Did you leave it anywhere where I could see it? I told her her sister, her children in Nigeria, passport number.
Amen.
I told her her NI.
Hallelujah.
NI number.
That's right.
NI number.
Amen.
That's not all. Guess what? The other time I came again, I was prophesying to her. She came in the office and said, Papa, someone told you. You see? Maybe someone told me something about her. Anyone here? Those are storms of life. They came to make her lose faith.
That's right.
They came to make her think. So it means even the end, I saw one to Papa. That's how it works. Those are storms of life. Storms of life. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They are self-imposed storms. They are physical storms. They are spiritual storms. And they are generational storms. I'll go gently. I would like to stand here. Again, anointing is not going up and down. The anointing can move you up and down. But anointing is not going. So we can stand there like Mama and Pastor David, and you are still anointed.
Amen.
I'm preaching against myself, right?
So feel free. Do what you do. Hallelujah.
Tomorrow, some of you say, Pastor, you were so right. If I don't tell you the truth, sir, I'm not your pastor.
Yes, sir.
A good father tells the sons, the daughter, the truth, even if he hurts them at that
time.
That's
right, that's right, that's right.
What I tell you today might hurt you, but tomorrow,
it will bless you.
You will know. It might be your, it's not paracetamol, it makes you drink that is very bitter. Panadol. Chloroquine. Even COVID tests, when they say go and do it, that's the first thing I dreaded when I miss my flight, because now I have to do another COVID test. There's nothing I hate like COVID test. And I went in there, I told that lady, she was just nice, like God sent her. I said, please, I don't like this thing. Say, don't worry, I'll just... I'll just put the bit. And that's what she did, she just put the bit. Normally, she's supposed to put in my mouth and in my both my nose. She only put in both my nose and she did not put in my mouth. She said, go. Say, favor. Uncommon favor. The remainder of this year.
Amen.
That is what will speak for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is what will speak for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Wherever you have been rejected before, the uncommon favor of God is speaking for you now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that. Amen at all.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Sit down. And for our prayers to be effective, we must first of all know the kind of storms that we are contending with. Ask yourself, are they self-imposed? Are they physical storms? Are they spiritual storms? Are they generational storms? You know, sir, even this ministry we are doing like this, my father told me clearly, say, the altars in your grandfather's house, they are still fighting the ministry. So not just enemies within, my own altars too. From tomorrow, I'll be the one to take those prayers, 11:30.
Hallelujah.
From tomorrow, sir. From tomorrow,
to scatter.
I'll be, it's like God made it so that, okay, I can miss a flight and stay there and begin to scatter them.
That's right.
We don't need to travel there to break, to destroy them. And he said that layers have been broken. Layers have been broken. You know, like an onion. An onion has layers. Say, but a few layers are still left. Say, just pray hard. Those layers too will be broken.
Amen.
Someone here, that strong man still standing.
Hey,
the remainder of this year.
Deliberate.
That one that has hit their chest, that you will not marry. That you will not be worried.
Woo.
That you will not have a permanent job.
Hey.
The remainder of this year, they go down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They will be exposed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If that is you, let your amen sound like thunder.
Amen.
Sit down, sir.
Thank you, Jesus. Holy Ghost.
A village I've never been. Don't even know the road. I don't even know the road to my village, sir. I don't know the road. If you tell me go there, I'll be busy. They know me there. Some of you just take lightly. Today I'll teach some things that you get you to understand certain things. Nothing just happens. Nothing just happens. The fact that there are spiritual powers that are assigned to put you in debt. You looking at me now? That ticket you had is not normal. It's not what?
Normal.
You think you are speeding by yourself? A foundation just press the remote control and before you know it, you are gone. They gave you a ticket.
That's right, sir.
You don't understand. How can I miss my flight? How can I miss my flight? Guess what? I missed the flight before I go in. I missed the flight when I was coming back.
Mercy,
call man. It traffic all you like. In Lagos, traffic was like 3 hours, 4 hours to get to the airport. Airport, 20 minutes. It's not...
No,
it is not.
No,
no, you care, you sing. It's not.
No, hallelujah.
You know Lagos.
Yes.
How can there be traffic for 4 hours at 5 a.m.? 5 a.m. People are not sleeping. And yet no new houses. And yet no new companies. It is not. By the way, Biafras or Nigerians, we're meant to do them next. We have not done them again.
Yes, sir.
No, you are Nigerian. Let me talk to you, sir, like a prophet. You are not, there's nothing like Biafra. You know, it's okay. You know, it's the same me that I said I saw them separating. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now, when we're doing Revelation classes, at one point I said, lockdown, April. It is push. It is new. Prophecy can change.
Amen.
That's one thing you guys understand. Prophecy. And every time I said it, a few days after they announced, push. Even this time around, I said, this one will be push. We'll push. It's push.
That's right. It was
prophecy can be.
To July now.
I said that I see them dividing. Can I tell you something? Media, put this on record. There will be no division. In Nigeria. Don't argue. You can argue outside. Don't argue yet. Listen to what I'm saying. There will be no division in Nigeria. I'm a professor. I've spoken. No division. Sir, we're not arguing. Can argue. You can argue outside, sir. Nnamdi Kanu, I saw him on a throne. Remember I said when I prophesied about the fire in London, I gave another prophecy. I said, I see the government making errors. And because of that error, youths will go on the streets and there will be fire and all that. The capture of Nnamdi Kanu is an error. Your Biafra people don't enter the streets. They're planted. They'll enter the street, just like I've told you. And when they enter the street, Nnamdi Kanu, whoever is in prison now. Though I see him sitting on a position. He will sit on that position. And the same you will say, what is the point? He is there. No more division.
Amen.
I have spoken.
Amen.
Sir, you can argue outside.
Finito.
Hallelujah.
Hey, finito.
Shout hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Massa so. Pray in tongues. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
When everybody was talking Trump will win again, I sat way in the office just praying, right? just praying. I closed my eyes and I was praying. And I just said to them, I said, I just saw Trump crying. You were there?
That's right. I
just saw Trump crying. And they asked why. I asked why. Say he has just lost the election. But everybody was saying that he will win. God is not backwards. God is recent. He might have said something yesterday. Ask him again, Lord, what are you saying?
That's right.
He may have said, go for that job. Wake up that morning. Ask him again, Lord, should I still go? Because what he told you yesterday might not be what he's saying now.
That's right.
What he said to you yesterday might not be what he's saying today, sir.
That's right.
That's why the Bible says that David won every battle of his life. Why? Because at every stage, every battle he went to, he asked, Lord, how do I win this battle?
Amen.
He didn't say, because I won it like this in the previous battle, I should go like that. That's what many of us do.
That's right.
We use the techniques of the old victory to enter a new battle. Error. So even this morning, I see, ask, Lord, do you want us to have a new property or do you want us to expand? Because he may have said yesterday, expand. Today he might say, okay, I'm giving you what? A new property. Sir, there is a way you can put heaven under pressure.
That's right.
There's a way. Nigeria will not go down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Minister Charles, is he thinking about it? One thing about God is that God is not, church is not politics. Does that make any sense? Church is not,
amen,
politics. God can show you something about what is going to happen, but it's not politics. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Child of God, like I said, confess positivity all you like. Change your name all you like. They say they want to change the name to what? Nigerian name. UAE. What does it mean? See the confusion. United what? Arab Emirate. That's what they want to be. Look at how confused they are. It is not a change of name that will bring your change of story. After all, there are people called Hope and they are so hopeless.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right.
There are people called Anointing. They are so annoying. So meet them. You're so annoying. So annoying. I remember those days when we used to date. I'll meet the girl. Her name is Joy. And I'll go for a date with Joy. Joy, there's nothing joyful about her. I could not even speak for 5 minutes.
Mercy.
She will see anything and abuse. She will see a car. I don't like this car. But yet she doesn't have a car. I say, if you try. I say, delay my number now.
Hallelujah.
I don't know how I gave him my number. I deleted that. Before I go. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
People call good news. Everything about them is a setback.
It's bad.
But yet they call themselves good news. People, my name is Mighty. They live very little lives. Even Ogada they don't have. Bicycle they don't have. Your name is Mighty. So it is not a change of name that matters. It is a change of identity. You have to get to that point where you grow from a caterpillar to a butterfly.
That's right.
That is what will answer for you this month in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that, amen, at all.
Amen.
I prophesy.
I receive
any storm that is still manifesting in any area of your life, in this second half of the year, they are broken by fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The remainder time of this year, you will not sweat in vain in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever your hands will touch, it shall prosper. He shall prosper. He shall prosper. He shall prosper. He shall prosper. In the name of Jesus. Whatever your hands have started, the remaining 6 months of this year, you will finish it by fire. You will finish it by fire. You will finish it by fire. In the name of Jesus. Sit down, please.
Thank you, Holy
Sit down and never go down.
Amen.
Quickly, let's look at number one storm. Self-imposed storms. Self-imposed storms. What are self-imposed storms? They are those storms that we bring upon ourselves. Many times it's not foundation. If you are here, you are still not talking to someone in the church, that's a self-imposed storm there. That's what the devil is using to gather your blessing. If you are here, you are still not talking to someone in church, that's a self-imposed storm. You know, we live in a society or a generation where there's this holy than thou. So, so holy, holy, holy. I was in Nigeria. And when I got to the airport, the church had to come and pick me up. So they wasted a bit of time because I arrived very early. And a gentleman took my bag. And he just stood on me because the security is a mess. And I gave him thousands of naira. Does that make sense? And the church came 30 minutes after. And he said to me, Oga, is this all you can give me? That's a self-imposed storm. Next time when I see him, I say, police, arrest him.
Hallelujah.
That's how they lose favor. In my hotel, I will give my things for dry cleaning every day. I like to wear fresh things when I'm out of here. It's not expensive. Hallelujah. Every day, I'll give them for dry cleaning. And they are very smart. They call it survival of the fittest. And these are people that God puts in your heart to bless them. And when they come, you don't give them, no, you must give tips. Those are, me, I give tips. I always give tips. But if it is 2,000, they'll put 6,000. Self-imposed storms. One specifically told me, whether it's one shed, one trust, I say it's 4,500. I just knew, but God has laid in my heart to bless him. Not giving him 1,000 of naira. Bless him. Bless him like 50,000. Bless him. So he came and he said, 4,500. But I knew that it is not 4,500. That's how he lost.
Mercy, Lord. Mercy, Jesus.
There are some monies you take today, it will stop other heavenly blessings from coming
That's
to you.
Right. Amen.
I'm telling you.
That's true, sir.
They call it survival of the fittest. I call it foolishness in high places.
Hallelujah.
Another one, I'll send him to go and buy me something. He'll come and double the price. And guess what? He will not even give me change.
That's right.
Obviously, I will not ask. Don't be bushwalla. I will not
ask.
And then that's how he lost favor. And he came to me and he started telling me problem. I don't have to give you. Did I not have? I had, but he just missed it. Self-imposed error. He did it to himself. Sleeping with a man, with a woman that you are not married with, self-imposed storm. Error.
Sinker of destiny.
Lies telling. Self-imposed storms. You put it on yourself. It is not God. It is not your foundation. Even though I'm saying that I went late because of my foundation, I was preparing my tickets late. Even me, self-imposed error.
You guys are looking at me. You know, I'll just say my own like that.
That's right.
Because foundation cannot stop me.
Mercy, Lord.
Why did it not stop me when I was coming back? The second time. It still stopped me the first time. In the name of traffic.
Talking about a grace that is speaking for you. Self-imposed storm. Familiarity. When you sit down and you talk about a sister, a brother, and you take them out of grace where God wants them to be, it is recorded against you. Self-imposed storms. Luke 17:1 quickly. Luke 17:1 quickly, because of time. It says what? Then said he unto the disciples. It is impossible but that offenses will come. When the Bible says woe, and that was Jesus speaking, but woe unto him through whom they come. Self-imposed stops. Many times we say foundation. Sir, it's not foundation many times. Many times we bring that storm upon our lives.
Yes, sir.
I'll show you examples in the Bible. Jonah, whether the fish swallowed him or he swallowed the fish, there was a swallowing.
That's right. There was a swallowing.
Self-imposed storm.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Look at Genesis 4:6-7 quickly. Genesis 4:6-7. Quickly, because of time. Genesis 4:6-7. It says what?
And the Lord
said unto Cain, why art thou? Now, he was angry. Now, Cain brought an offering. Abel brought an offering. And Cain wasn't happy because Abel's offering was accepted, but his offering was rejected. Not because of foundation. Not because of Abel.
That's right.
Many of you are fighting your brothers and your sister. It's not them you have to fight. Hallelujah.
That's right.
It's not them you have to fight. Look at yourself.
That's right.
Is it an error from me?
That's right.
Is it an error from me? He was fighting his brother, angry with his brother. You see, your sister wears a new dress. It's so fine. You are like, where did she even get money to get this dress? Say, so he took to buy a car. Hallelujah. Let's read.
Mercy,
he says what?
Mercy.
Verse. And the Lord said, and if thou, look at that.
Well.
If thou doest well. If you were also in service on the day the blessing was released, you too would have been blessed.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If thou doest well, shall your own offering Cain not be accepted? He said what? Sin lieth at the door. And unto thee what? Shall be his desire. And thou shalt rule over
him.
You see how it was reversed? Because someone did something that glorified God, and the other one brought self-imposed storms upon himself in the name of Cain. Some women, sir, as my father will say, they cannot have children today because of what happened in the past.
That's right.
Some women cannot get married today because of what happened in the past, and vice versa. Some men are infertile. When I just got married, they said I had low sperm count. Sir, I don't know what may have happened. But I know that when I gave my life to Christ, God showed me a girl that I slept with when I was still in the world. He said, when you slept with her, something was fired into you. And that is why you have not had a child. That's why they are saying low sperm count. And I began to deal with it woman, by myself, for myself. And that yoke was broken. Sometimes it's not God, it is you. Look again. I'm sorry. I'm not talking about Nigeria. It's like that in every other country. Now, girls in Nigeria, young girls, even in your hotel room, they come and knock. Oga can serve you. God, she's looking at me.
That's right.
That's why I'm. Yeah, I know they do it here, but what I'm saying is, I'm telling you my experience. I've not seen it yet. I'm telling you my experience. I don't know what is happening here. I've not seen it yet. I'm telling you my experience. Sir, many of them, they come from well-to-do backgrounds. You'll be shocked. It's not that your fathers are broke. Self-imposed storm.
Their father cannot buy them that clothes that every one of their friends is wearing. So they must do something extra. And it's like a business. It's like Yahoo boy, Yahoo girl. It's like a business. It's like what? A business. Everything you do today, sir, the consequences are waiting tomorrow. As long as the earth remained, there is seed time and harvest. Self-imposed stops. The one you and I put on ourselves. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord was literally saying to Cain, that Cain, no matter how prayerful you are, look at your surface. No matter how prayerful you are, there are many people praying, but it is not going beyond the roof. You must deal with self-imposed. It might be addiction. It might be masturbation. It might be loss of the eyes. It might be loss of
flesh.
The flesh. It might be vainglory. You must deal with it first. Self-imposed
storm.
Anytime, I'm telling you, sir, I'm a man, I've been there. Anytime you begin to lust for people, self-imposed storm. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God said to Cain in verse 7, if thou doest well, shall thou not be accepted? Meaning that if Cain could break that self-imposed storm, then he too will be accepted. I believe that Cain was probably dealing with false prophets. Now, when I went down there, they call an offering for those who want to help with the church. 1 million. And I was rushing. And the first thing Mama said to me, that I would have been surprised if I did not see you. I would have been surprised. Anyone that tells you, sir, that giving is not of God, check their life. They are broke, brokers, broke. They are. As long as you are led, does that make sense? As long as you are led, they are. Yeah. And those are people who may stop you, who the enemy may use to make you impose self storms upon yourself. So you must be careful which voice you are hearing. You must what? Be careful which voice you are hearing. That's why many people, they buy things and they don't last. You buy a car. Today, garage. Tomorrow, garage. Wednesday, garage. Thursday, garage. Friday, is it granite? The devourer is devouring. Hallelujah. The what? The devourer is devouring.
Mercy, Lord.
Self-imposed thumbs. Child of God, show me everyone that speaks against giving. Check their life. They are beggars. And this is why many Christians are still struggling. Because they are not consistent with anything. You pay your tithe today. Tomorrow you don't pay. The one you gave last month was an offering. Start paying your tithe.
Amen. Amen.
I'll travel and I told Pastor David and Mama, I said, get my car to the garage. I was not doubting that it will not pass MOT. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Get it to the garage. For how many years now? Almost 6 years. I am only to change tires now.
That's right.
Some of us, every day we change tire. The devourer is devouring. You don't give it to God, you will give it to the devil.
Mercy.
Somehow.
One or the other.
One or the other. Mm. So you choose. Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
You choose.
You choose.
Malachi 3:6-11 is clear. Bring into my storehouse all the time. He said, then I'll open you up the gates of heaven. Shower unto you what?
A blessing.
So if I didn't have money, I would have been stuck in Nigeria. Hallelujah. I would have been stuck in Nigeria.
That's it.
I will open you up a blessing that day. Some of you are still going and you are looking at things. How much is the price? There's a level where you don't look price.
Hallelujah.
Oh, you see how they are quiet, sir. They are quiet. Sir, there is a level you don't look at the price.
Amen.
You don't look
at the price.
Before now, when I want to give you £10, I'll be counting. Now, as I put my hand, anything I see, take.
Amen.
There is a level you don't look at the price. Mama will say, do you know even how many naras are that? I said, I don't care. I don't know me the exchange. I don't even want to know me the how much. There's a level. It's a level. It says it's a realm.
It's a realm.
It's a realm, sir. It's a realm.
Hallelujah.
It's what? It is a realm.
Amen.
Say, oh Lord, take me to that realm.
Oh Lord, take me to that realm.
No, we said the last time that it doesn't matter whether I enter first class or second class. Sir, there's a difference, no? First class. Extra room, sir.
It matters.
No, it doesn't matter. The way you have your money, it's okay.
Okay, it's okay.
Extra room, sir. Comfort. Why they are giving you 1 million in the economy in the first class? What do you want? How do you want it? They don't just give you, they serve you on top. In economic, they package it. They package it like takeaway. Say you, yeah.
Take away.
It is a realm.
Hallelujah.
You don't understand.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's why I cannot say someone is humble. Because if they are broke, they will be, what else would they be? They must be humble now. They must be what?
Humble.
They don't have a choice, sir. They'll be humble.
Yes, sir.
That's why it's very important, even when having a choice of a husband or a wife, you should be careful. Because they want you, for example, go and bring in Africa. What will it be? Humble. A prophet must see.
Humblest.
That's where a prophet comes in, to see how he will react when he gets
future.
Blessed.
That's right.
Does that make sense, sir? Yeah. If not, he will come here and be telling you what to do. You don't want to know. You want to know the character of a man, sir? Give him money. Give him power.
That's right.
What destroy great men? Money, power, and women.
Women. Yes, sir. Women. Sir, you have to add them.
Money, power and women. If a man can conquer those three things,
that's right.
His life and his generation is very long.
Hallelujah.
Very long. Before now, when I was going 5 years ago, I'll be checking how much did you pay for this hotel. Now, just book it first class, the best. I want a suit.
That's right.
There is a
realm
where it is wrong, sir, is when someone does not have, then he wants to meet up.
That's right. You want to
be contented with where you are.
That's right.
Now. And believe God for the best.
Amen.
Does that make any sense? Yes. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, hallelujah is not good enough.
Hallelujah.
Every time the children of Israel sinned, did you notice that they attracted storms upon themselves?
That's right.
God withdrew from them. Every time they sinned,
that's right.
They attracted what? Impose storms upon themselves. Solomon, very powerful. Wisdom personified. But when he polluted that wisdom, we see what happened. He went down. Sin is a self-imposed storm. Sin of any kind.
That's right.
No matter what, there's no black sin, there's no white sin.
Sin is sin.
Sin is sin.
That's right.
Even just saying this microphone is 100 and I give you for 300 is sin.
Yes, sir.
I've defrauded you.
Yes, sir.
Self-imposed storms. What killed the most anointed man on earth, Samson? A woman. Self-imposed storm. Sir, most often it is not God. Check your life.
Amen.
When you are going through something repeatedly, again and again and again, you have prayed. Many of us pray all night. But you realize that the more you pray, the more the problem. Mm. If it's not this one, it's this one. If it's not this one, it's this one. Check your life. Yes. Lord, what could have been the problem? I've told you, God showed me a girl clearly. He said, son, when you slept with this girl, this particular year, about 20 years ago, something was fired into you. Say she was from the Marine Kingdom. Mm. And that was a prayer point for me. And I began to pray. And I began to pray. And I began to pray. And when mama came, we did not struggle. Lobu.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
But I had to deal with myself first.
That's right.
I wasn't blaming her. She had her own self-imposed storms that she had to deal with.
Right.
I had my own. When you see things repeating themselves again and again and again, and you've done all you know how to do and nothing happens, sit down. Lord, tell me, where is the... Because until you hit the source of that problem, it will keep carrying on.
Right.
You can't kill a tree by the branches. You must kill it from the roots.
The roots.
There's a source to every problem. We have people who think they know too much. In this church, there are people I cannot talk to. More, I cannot talk me to them. It's either they even tell you, yes, I'll do, and then they go behind. We know.
Hallelujah.
The church is a hospital. Their medication is not healing them yet. One day, go heal them. As a doctor, I'm just patient. The day your medication will heal you, it will heal you. I'm telling you, in this church, they'll tell you, they'll do that. Some people, you'll talk to them and they will say yes. Then they'll wait until you give them an opportunity. Say, pastor, don't you think? Now they are trying to bring their point that day indirectly.
That's right. That's
God
right.
Sees your heart. Mm. He knows. They are trying to counteract what you said that day, but in a canny way.
That's right. Hallelujah.
Even in marriage, sir, that's why many marriages are broken. You tell your wife something. I'm just giving an example. It's not what is happening. And she'll be like, yes. Suddenly, there's a family meeting. And in a way, my husband, I like you, eh? And then indirectly, she's bringing that point. Let's stand up on our feet.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Perfect.
That's right.
Me, you see, I make so many errors.
Mercy, Lord.
You may say, pastor, you have wisdom, but guess what? I make so many. That ticket, could I not finish the previous day? Could I not check in the previous day? That's an error. I make so many errors. Is it the first time I'm missing a flight? No, sir. Self-imposed errors. I don't even want to blame my foundation. I brought it to myself. Now, when I have a flight, 3 hours before time, sir. You took me to the airport the next time. What happened? I was there just with, I was a security man.
Member of staff.
I almost went and tell the security man, give me a hat, let me wear.
That's right, they knew.
We will guide this place.
Hallelujah.
sir, when things keep repeating themselves, check your life.
Amen. Amen.
Joshua was winning with his people.
That's right.
Then suddenly they started losing battles. Joshua said, what is happening? And Joshua went back to God. And God said to Joshua, relax. They have sinned again. It is their sin. 5,000 men at one point, they died in a day. They died like lizard. People were dying like lizard. Sin is a self-imposed storm. Joshua 7:7. Let's read quickly. From verse 7. Let's read. Joshua 7:7. Quickly, because of time. It says what? Joshua 7:7. Let's read 1-3, go. It says what?
And Joshua said, alas, O Lord God,
wherefore how thou at all brought these people over Jordan, to deliver us into the hand of the Amorites. So, the same people they were winning, God delivered them into the hands to destroy them. He said, would to God we had been content. You see, look at that. And dwell on the other side, Jordan. Verse 8, quickly, because of time. It says what? Oh Lord, what shall I say? When Israel turned their backs before their enemies. Next verse. It says, for the Canaanites and all the inhabitants of the land shall hear of it and shall environ us round and cut off our name from the earth. And what will that do unto what? That great name. Next verse, quickly, because of time. It says what?
And the Lord said
unto Joshua, look at that now. Get up, relax. Get thee up. Wherefore, liest thou down, open thy face. Verse 11, quickly, because of time. It says, Israel has sinned, and they have also transgressed my covenant, which I commanded them. For they have even taken of the accursed things. So they are cursed things. They are things that God does not want us to touch, but many of us will go and touch. When you eat your tithe, you touch God's money, whether you know it or not. Say, the tithe belongs to me. And he says what? Which I commanded them. For they have even taken what? Of the accursed thing. And have also stolen. And they are people that God has rejected that you are still friends with. Once you join with such people, what happened? You have connected yourself to something that God has rejected. And whatever consequences comes to them, it comes to you too. It says, and disabled also. And they have put it even among their own stuff. We go to work and we steal pens. And we take things that don't belong to us. Those are self-imposed error. And we wonder why next time we lose that job. We've opened the road for the enemy.
Jesus.
Verse 12, it says what? Now, I'll tell you a story. Many of you are just looking at me like I've lost my mind. In my previous church, sir, I left church one day with a pen. Say a pen.
A pen.
You can pick a pen anywhere. I've driven almost to my house. The Holy Ghost said, you just stole a pen from my house. Turn back, just as you are. Look for the next 10. Turn back and go and return
the pen.
You're just looking at me like that. A pen, sir. A pen. I kept it among my own things, but it is something that I should not have touched in the first place. And I did not steal, I forgot. I'm very good. I can enter your office now, just take your pen and I forget. I go with it. It says what? It says, because they were cursed, neither will I be with you anymore, except you what? Ye destroy the accursed from among you. Verse 13, quickly. It says, sanctify the people. And say, sanctify yourself against tomorrow. For thou said the Lord God of Israel, there is an accursed thing in the midst of thee, O Israel. Thou cannot stand before thy enemies until you take away the accursed thing from among you. Verse 14. In the morning, therefore, ye shall be brought according to your tribes. And it shall be that the tribes which the Lord taketh shall come according to the families thereof. And the family which the Lord shall take shall come by households. And the household which the Lord shall take
shall come man by man. Mercy, Lord.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want us to just pray a prayer. Set yourself. Oh, Lord.
My God.
I've heard your word. And I did not just go and return the word, the pen. Holy Ghost told me, go and apologize to the pastor of the church. Sir, a pen, it doesn't make sense. Search me, Lord. Any self-imposed errors. Self-imposed errors that I brought upon myself. Self-imposed storms. Lord, leak it away in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and we give you prayer.
Leak it away.
Father, Lord.
Oh, yes.
Leak
it away.
Oh, yes. Self-imposed on.
I wish someone was
Lord, there. Even as we have heard your counsel. Lord, search me, Lord. Lord, yeah, I am.
Even
Lord.
As we have heard counsel.
In the name of Jesus.
We
search
come before you. That you will search us.
Pray. That pride, take it away.
Search us, so God.
That familiarity, take it away.
Me,
that stubbornness, take it away.
Lord,
that rebellion, take it away.
That arrogance, take it away.
Every time, oh God,
take it away.
We have been deceived.
Loyalty, take it away.
Learn to think with this regard.
Spiritual and prophetic instruction.
We can engage in it and still receive from God. It is an error. It is an error. Father, search us. Search us.
Lord, search me.
Search us this morning.
Search word and firm
ministry. Holy Ghost, lick up every self imposed
thumb. Every
self imposed thumb
that
is limiting us.
Lord, repent from us.
By the
Lord,
power of the Spirit.
From it.
Hey, Lato Seba Nagate. Retakobe Nakabrakoba Os.
Take it away from me, Lord.
Oh, Holy Ghost, lick it
take
up.
Take it away.
The loss of the
lick
flesh.
It up, lick it
the
up.
Loss
take
of
it away from
every
me.
Every evidence of sin.
Take it away from
that is walking against us.
Lick it up.
Abalaste be lato be nata.
Lick it up.
Oh Jesus.
Thank you and thank you and
thank you.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Stretch your hand here. Let me release a blessing. The Bible speaking in Deuteronomy your enemies 28:13. It said the Lord will make you the head and not the tail. I therefore decree and I declare upon 10 persons hearing the sound of my voice. By the written word of God, the remaining 6 months of this year, you will be the head only and not the tail in the name of Jesus. Then number 7 stands for perfection. Therefore, I prophesy. May God perfect all that you have started in the name of Jesus. The remainder of this year, I declare and declare, anyone assigned to delay you, anyone assigned to hijack your blessing, may they be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. As you go, may the blessing of God be with you in the name of Jesus. May all your divine helpers remember you in the name of Jesus. Anyone sick here, be healed in the name of Jesus. Anyone sick in your family, by the power of the Holy Ghost, let them be healed in the name of Jesus. Let them be made whole in the name of Jesus. Go and return back with a testimony in Jesus' name. If that is you, let your amen be louder. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Thank him. Thank him. Say, neighbor. Go to your neighbor, prophesy. Neighbor, the remainder of this year. Tell them something, prophesy.